In this lecture, I will walk you through the event management use case that you will be working on throughout the rest of this course as you explore all the super cool features that Spring Data REST has to offer. An event could be a group of friends getting together to play games, to watch movies, or to simply eat lunch. Or it could be a corporate meeting, or even a wedding or an engagement or a music concert. We are going to create an event management API, which is a microservice using Spring Data REST, and we'll expose it out as RESTful web service, which can then be consumed by an event management web application or a mobile application so that the end user can create and manage their events. So we'll be building an event management API project using Spring Data REST. Getting to the lower level details, to look at the entities or the resources in this application, event, it all starts with an event which will be created by an organizer of that event. So organizer is one resource, then we have event, and when the organizer creates an event, he will provide the venue information, where exactly that event is going to happen, and also he will provide details such as the start time, the end time, etc. Once the event is in place, the next resource we'll be dealing with is the participants. Who all are interested in participating in that event can check into that event. The organizer at any point can start the event. Once the start time happens, he will go into that venue and he will start the event. He can at any point in time read the details of that event, update the event details, or even delete that event. So you are going to build this microservice in the next few lectures. But the key here is to remember these four resources: the event, the organizer who creates the event, the venue where the event happens, and the participants who can participate in that event.